The trick is with this is to have enough liquid in there that it binds, but not too much that it is too liquidy. So just add your stock a little bit at a time. And then that way you know kind of the consistency that you want.
So question about the olive oil. How do you pick out a good olive oil? Like what do you look for? Are there any good brands that you recommend or?
Definitely tasting is ideal for olive oils. So if you do have the chance to taste them before you buy them, that's huge. Moroccan olive oils are quite nice for a decent price. And then just reading the bottle, to be honest with you, and knowing what you're buying, definitely. But tasting them, if you have a chance to taste before you buy, that's huge. Because a lot of the olive oils on the market are quite bitter. Everything says extra virgin on it, but some of them, the flavor is definitely not there. So if you can taste it before you buy it, that's fantastic. And like I said, Moroccan olive oils are quite good these days, and they're a little bit cheaper. So now my stuffing is the consistency that I want to be. Touch more liquid. And then I'm just gonna add some chopped parsley in there as well.
Could you use dried herbs in your stuffing or?
Yeah, so today this is dry herbs, but if you have the chance to use fresh herbs, I would say it's a better alternative. Obviously, sometimes we don't have the ability to use them, so if you have dry herbs in your house already in the cupboard, works just as well. Obviously, when you're at home making your big dinner, you're going to have a little bit more stuffing than that. But there you go. Just wrap it in tinfoil, and then you're going to put it in the oven. And then take the tinfoil off right before you're done just to get the color on there. Just going to check our potatoes here. Almost done. All right. The trick to a good mashed potato is making sure that your potatoes are nice and dry. That's why I put it back on the heat here. If you have the thyme at home, just let it dry in your strainer, and then that's going to get you a much better result at the end. And it's going to be a much fluffier mashed potato. I do have a ricer here today, so I'm going to rice the potatoes into there. That's a little trick that we have in the professional kitchens, but if you don't have one at home, they do have hand ricers that you can use. You just press them together, or you can just use your masher at home. Either way works fine. Bit of a struggle here. And we're just going to put a little bit of butter in with those potatoes.
I love how the kitchen is pretty clean after you're cooked a traditional turkey dinner. My kitchen looks like a bomb when goes off in it after I'm done.
Yeah.
Yeah. A well-trained chef, I guess.
Definitely a bit of a,
yeah,
bit of a time crunch in 25 minutes. But I mean, if you have the time to do, like I said, the brine and stuff like that the day before, you can get most of this prep done the day before. And then it makes your turkey dinner Christmas Day much, much easier for you and much more enjoyable. All right. And we've got our vegetables. We're going to put a touch of olive oil in them. Some salt and a little bit more of that chopped garlic. And then we're going to go right in our pan here. Nice and hot, so we get a nice, good roast on them. All right. And look at that, our stuffing is good to go. And so is our turkey. So like I said, can't really tell that it was green beforehand. It's got some nice color on there. And you'll be able to see when I cut into the turkey just how juicy it is. So we'll cut the legs off here first. And then we'll go ahead with the breast. As you can see, super moist from that brine. Little bit messy. All right, so we're ready to plate. like I said, just a little bit of veggie stock to finish off. Our veggies there. We've got a nice sear and then just finished with some veg stock.
Just while you're plating there, I'll just mention all the recipes were sent today in an attachment to an email. But if you haven't got it, just shoot me a message with your email in it or email me at carrie.celine@tastealberta.ca and I'll send you the link or the recipes. There's not really a link that'll be online, but I can certainly attach it to an email. And that looks so delicious. That turkey looks really, really moist.
And that's it. Dinner served.
Nice.